In this example, we are given that a particle of mass 7 charge plus Q is thrown with a speed U at an angle theta with the horizontal. It is saying if in a space an electric field of strength E exists in vertically downward direction, we are required to find the horizontal range of this projectile. Here we can draw the physical situation like if this ground and a particle of mass 7 charge Q is thrown at an angle theta with the horizontal, it follows a projectile and fall back on ground. In this situation, during its flight, it will experience a downward effective gravity G effective, which is equal to G plus QE by M. Because we are given that in downward direction an electric field E also exists. So net force acting on the particle in downward direction will be its weight plus the electric force QE. So resulting effective gravity can be taken as G plus QE by M. Now in this situation, if it is thrown with the speed U, it will be having two components, U cos theta in horizontal direction, which will remain constant, and U sin theta is in vertical direction, which will be affected by this effective gravity. Now, using this vertical direction of motion, we can find out the time of flight of this particle as t is equals to 2u sin theta by g effective, which is written as 2u sin theta by g plus qe by m. And in this situation, if we are having the time of flight, horizontal range of projectile can be directly given as r is equals to u cos theta multiplied by the time of flight. So in this situation, this can be given as u cos theta multiplied by 2u sin theta by g plus qe by m. So this will be u square sin 2 theta divided by g plus qe by m. That will be the answer to this problem. Here you can also see that the result of range remains same, which is that of a normal projectile. The only difference is G is replaced by the effective gravity in this situation.